My presentation topic is the intersection curve of two surfaces in n-dimensional Euclidean space. We can look at the subject under the following heading. Firstly, I would like to give you an overview of surface-surface intersection, and I give some basic concepts. Then I introduce our methods, and finally, I give an example. In geometric, in computer-aided geometric design, the surface-surface intersection problem it is an important problem. If we have a curve as an intersection curve, it is hard to compute the Frenet vectors and curvatures. Depending on the linear independency of the normal vectors of surfaces or hypersurfaces, the intersection is called transversal, non-transversal, or tangential intersection. To study this kind of problem, different methods have been given in the 3, 4, and n-dimensional Euclidean space. The parametric surface intersection problem has been studied in n space recently, but the other problem haven't studied now. So the purpose of our study to compute all Frenet vectors and curvatures of the intersection curve to implicit surfaces and implicit parametric surfaces in n-dimensional Euclidean space. In this part, I mentioned some basic concepts. The vector product of n minus one vectors and the magnitude or the norm of the this vector product given by the S these formulas, and we give a regular surface in n-dimensional Euclidean space. Let v1 to vn denotes the Frenet frame of a unit speed curve alpha. The Frenet formulas are given by this equation. We need this equation to obtain the higher order derivative of the curve alpha. And moreover, in implicit surfaces as in n-dimensional space, can be defined as the intersection of n-2 intersection, intersection of n-2 implicit surfaces. So if the surface M given by the implicit equation Fi and for the curve alpha, we can write this equation. The first equation is the dot product gradient of Fi and the alpha prime is Q0. By taking the both sides of this equation, we get the other equation, or in general form, is given in equation 6. In this part, I introduce our method. Let M1 and M2 be transversal intersection regular surfaces given by Fi and Gi, respectively, in n-dimensional Euclidean space. The normal space of Mi and M2 spanned by these normal vectors. We know that the normal vectors of Mi are linearly independent, and similarly, the normal vectors of M2 are linearly independent. So we assume that these surfaces intersect along vector alpha, and we consider the set S, and let V be the dimension of the subspace spanned by S at an intersection point. We have three situations. If V is a closed N, the intersection point is an isolated point. If D is equals n-2, then we have the tangential intersection, and D is the equals n-1, we have the transversal intersection at intersection point. In the study, we focus the transversal intersection, and we assume that D is equals n-1. So we suppose that we suppose that n-1 linearly independent normal vectors. We can choose a gradient of G mu, a normal vector of M2, to be linearly independent with the normal vectors of the surface M1. And we can this unit tangent vector V1 is orthogonal to these normal vectors. So the vectoral vector product of the these vectors is give us the first Frenet vector. If we have the v1, thus v x1 prime, x2 prime, and xn prime can be found by using the equation 7. Since alpha double prime is orthogonal to v1, alpha double prime can be written as a linear combination of the normal vectors. So we need to compute the scalar sıkı I to obtain alpha double prime. By taking the dot product of both sides with the normal vectors, we have a linear equation system. The coefficient of linear equation system has non-zero determinant. Then we can use the grammar methods, the solution of the system we obtain as the kısa I coefficient. And here, the dot product of alpha double prime and gradient G nu and alpha double prime and gradient F G are can be computed by using the equation 2. So substituting of the kısa I into the equation 8 gives us the alpha double prime. Thus, x1 double prime, x2 double prime, and x1 xn double prime can be obtained by using the alpha double prime. We by using the Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization method, we get the u2 and second Frenet vector and the first curvature of the intersection curve. For the third order derivative vector of the intersection curve, we can write the alpha third order derivative equation in 11. Similarly, by taking the dot product of the both sides equation 11 with the normal vectors, we have a linear equation system and we need to compute the rho I coefficient. We can solve the solution given by the equation 12. We can compute, we get the rho I coefficient. Then substitution of the rho I into the 11 gives alpha third prime. And finally, besides using the Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization, we get the third Frenet vectors and second curvature and Q1 prime at intersection curve at intersection point. For the higher order derivative, we can write the equation 14. Similarly, we need to compute the sigma I coefficient by taking the dot product of the both sides of with normal vectors. We obtain rho I coefficient and we can calculate to this vector. But in higher derivative, it is difficult to calculate the coefficient C1. Therefore, this coefficient is calculated by using the MATLAB code given in references 3. We also using the Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization method, we get the VR Frenet vector, and the last Frenet vector is computed by the vector product of V1 from V1 to Vn minus 1. And we get the curvatures of in equation 17. The other side is our method is intersection of parametric and implicit surfaces. If we take a parametric surfaces, we have the we can define an orthogonal basis for the normal of x, and the implicit equation is the gradient vectors are normals. So we can consider transversal intersection, and we need to n minus one linearly independent normal vectors. For this purpose, we can take the n minus one linearly independent normal to compute to v1, the unit tangent vector of our intersection curve. By taking both products of v1, x u and x y, that gives us u prime and v prime, and using the equation 18, we get the x1 prime, x2 prime, and xn prime. For the second order derivative, we can write the linear combination of the normal split for alpha double prime by taking the dot product of the this equation with the normal vectors. We have the solution of the system of linear equation lambda e. Here the this coefficient can be found as given in previous equation, and we get the second Frenet vector and first curvature, our intersection curve. If we continue in a similar way for our order derivative of the intersection curve, we can write this equation by taking the dot product with normal vectors. We can the mu e coefficient, and using the Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization method, we get the Frenet vectors and curvature as given in the equation. Now I give an example our method. If we take two implicit surface in n-dimensional, in four-dimensional Euclidean space, we can see the projection of the intersection surfaces n1 and n2 as figure. We try to find the Frenet vectors and curvatures at the point P. The normal vectors phi of these surfaces are, and we have the at intersection point these tangent vectors. So as we can see, these vectors are linearly independent at intersection point. So we have a transversal intersection. Using the equation 7, we can find the unit tangent vector at intersection point P, and it gives us x1 prime, x2 prime, x3 prime, and x4 prime. For the second order derivative, we can write the alpha double prime as a linear combination of the normal vectors. We try to find the PCI coefficient, and using the 9 and 2, we get this coefficient, and the second Frenet vector is given, and the first curvature of our intersection curve at P. By using the 11, equation 11, we can write the third order derivative. Similarly, we try to find the rho I coefficient in this equation. So if we use the our equation, we can obtain the third Frenet vector and second curvature of our intersection curve. If we continue in a similar manner, we can find the last Frenet vector and last curvature at intersection point P. These are my references. Thank you for your attention.